madness. There's hundreds and hundreds of trekkers trying to get on their flights, and nobody really seems to know where they're going. Our guide has taken our passports and promises to return with good news about our flight. And so we're just gonna hope for the best and hope we can get out of here today. Had our breakfast here in the Lukla airport, and we are finally ready to start walking. This is our wolf pack of four. Me, Janie, Ornelia, and Eric.
Cross the river and cross it slow. Been looking hard for the way to go. In the mirror I see a fire that's burning out the old worn out light. I see the problem that's on my hands. Fight the feelings and make my plans. And cross the river and cross it slow. Keep your head up steady as you go. Another day and another night. Everything is gonna be alright. Everything is gonna be alright. Yeah, everything's gonna be alright. Yeah, everything's gonna be alright. Yeah, everything is gonna be alright. Yeah, everything is gonna be alright.
What did we do today, Janie?
We hiked from Pocting to Namche Bazaar, so I think longest day in mileage, about 10 miles, and then gained about 3,000 feet in elevation, so it was pretty uphill for the last 5 miles, and we're at about 11,000 something feet.
On our Fitbits, it shows how many flights of stairs you walked up, and we registered 312 today. Been impressed with the modern amenities. We've had hot showers, electricity, good food at each stop that we've been at. The rooms here are right above the area where we ate, and it's pretty basic. There's basically just rooms divided by wooden dividers and just two twin beds, but pretty good views.
And what did you get when we got to Namche?
Janie got her first latte of the trip.
Maybe the last.
Broken minds. You're not alone, no, not tonight. Someone cares, just hold on tight. And cross the river and cross it slow. Keep your head up steady as you go. Another day and another night. Everything is gonna be alright.
Yeah, everything's gonna be alright. It's a wet one today. It's raining the whole day. But our trusty guide, Ganesh, with his purple umbrella, is gonna fearlessly lead us through the rain and on to our next stop.
Okay, so I'm documenting our room, which for the first time has an attached bathroom, which is luxurious, although, as you can see, not much privacy. we're at about 14,004, something like that. We both started to get a killer headache today, so we started Diamox, which... which the unfortunate side effect is that you have to go to the bathroom a lot. We've been in our room less than an hour, and we have gone to the bathroom 4 times.
Today was definitely our most challenging day on the trail so far. It rained and was very windy for 5 hours. Right now it's Snickers time. Good time of the day. Rest day tomorrow. And hopefully it clears up so we can see some peaks. After 2 days of rain, we finally have the answer to what's surrounding us. And it is incredible.
Not a soul up ahead and nothing behind. There's a desert in my blood and a storm in your eyes. Am I the king of nothing at all? And you're the queen of nothing at all. Will I remember the fight and I forget the pain? I got my hand in your pocket and my key in your chain. Am I the king of nothing at all? And you're the queen of nothing at all.
Go from Namche, where we are here, to base camp.
One foot in front of the other.
Mount Everest. Rock scrambling through a glacier, making up the trail as we go to get to base camp. There's an avalanche going on in the background. What could be better than that?
The good part about taking a shortcut to get to base camp is there's no crowds. The bad part is there's lots and lots of boulders to cross. Base camp, here we come.
Across my heart, you hope to die. Taking this one step at a time. I got your back, you got mine. One foot in front of the other. One foot in front of the other. One foot in front of the other.
Made it to base camp, Janie. How are you feeling?
Pretty good. Long day, but very cool to be here.
Very cool.
Ooh,
just standing there at the base of Mount Everest and looking up at it is something I'll never forget. After just climbing 17,000 feet, you look up and it's still 10,000 feet above you. As beautiful and as picturesque as those mountains were, they can be scary. We heard and saw avalanches, rock slides, and there's a constant buzz of helicopters going, flying over us, back and forth, to rescue people from different parts along the trail. And it really makes you think. I mean, it's a dangerous place. This morning, right after breakfast, we watched multiple helicopter rescues right from where we were staying to take people down from the groups that we were staying with just last night.
Steep that is, and then show them all the rocks I could pull.
There's a rock coming, there is snow, there's rock coming, that's why little quickly I think it's better safety.
Oh, that's comforting. Our porter Ram is carrying more weight than all of us, and he's crossing this glacier in vans because that's how he rolls.
Okay, so we just saw this huge rock slide right over there, which is right where we walked about 10 minutes ago. So that's terrifying. Hopefully nobody was right under there, but there's a big group about to come through again, so I'm ready to be off the glacier.
In the attics of the city night, we talked Corso in the MC5, and you could dance live. We were all
right. This glacier is a very strange place. It's just gray for as far as you can see. We're hoping this isn't another one of Ganesh's shortcuts. If all goes well, though, we'll end up in Gokyo on the other side.
No place to go, but everywhere. When I met in a Green Mountain State, I dropped out, he moved away. Heard he got some land out south, changed his name to a name the birds could pronounce. And only the wild ones give you
something I never wanted, but I pulled the ragged and the rush of the one night air. All the wild ones, all the ones you can never catch. The stars are up now, no place to go but everywhere.
Janie has now spotted a baby cow, and of course, we all need to stop for it.
Two days old.
Oh,
so precious.
Jane just spent way too much time with that cow. Now we need to run in order to catch our flight. Just kidding. So, we are back at Lukla here at the airport, and it's very cloudy today. It was cloudy yesterday as well, and no flights have taken off. So, we're kind of stuck here. I've been here for several hours, but thankfully, a guide from our company has a friend who just so happens to be a helicopter pilot, and has offered to take us back to Kathmandu via helicopter for a small fee. Sitting here in the Kathmandu airport, getting ready to leave Nepal, definitely some bittersweet feelings. It's been an amazing trip. I think we're both ready for toilet seats and
toilet paper
and drinkable water again. But definitely going to miss waking up and walking to a new place every day, seeing snow-capped mountains, and being surrounded by some of the most beautiful scenes I've ever seen. It's been really nice not having to worry about the normal daily stresses and only have to think about where you're going to walk to and what you're going to order. It has been unlike any place we've ever been, and it has been very, very nice. Where should we go next? There's a spark in you and a spark in me. So get up, let's take the lead. You can walk faster.
I hope the babies are still in Namche. I'm gonna go say hi to them. You're done.
That wasn't very good at
Namche. Anything you wanna say?
We climbed mountains and we took the leap. Had our hearts broken and it cut so deep.